Yo guys, what is going on? It is your boy Nick from On the Foot Market. I gotta center myself here. I moved my camera this morning. I had to move one of my monitors to another place and I have to still move it back. Anyways guys, a video today, another one of these videos kind of talking with you guys about just look ahead things and like preparement things. Like the last video I made was Bundesliga team of season. If you haven't checked it out, you guys gotta go look at it. Talking about a lot of buy times in the week, talking about a lot of times that I think you guys can make some coins. But this video today is going to be strictly about team of the season discard cards and my genuine thoughts on them, because I have a lot of thoughts regarding the next 2 weeks. And there was something that I started to talk about the other day about these team of the season cards. So guys, if you enjoy the video, smash a like. If you don't, you don't have to smash a like. If you guys are new, subscribe. That's important. You guys don't want to miss the uploads. A lot of preparement, good videos coming up for you guys in the next week. So first thing I want to look at is obviously team of the season cards. So you have them down at 60K right now. You've actually got a goalkeeper in the Bundesliga at 61. Is that his true price? No, that's his snipe. So 60K right now is the cheapest. I feel like there's more team of the season cards coming onto the game, so there's less demand for a certain group of cards. There's more demand. There's demand all over the place, right? But there's more cards now to submit in the SBC. So I think every time we get more cards that are discard value, like these rest of the worlds, the harder it is for these guys to go up. Now, saying this, why are we investing in these? Well, we are investing in these for the SBCs that come out every Sunday and Tuesday that require team of the season cards. That's why we invest in these, right? So I'm looking at it realistically. They're at 60K. They usually go up a little bit on the first SBC, and the second SBC is the real rise. I think Tuesday, I think they're going to be 70K. I think they'll be around 70K, 72, 73. I don't think they're going to be much higher. So that's just to tell you guys. I feel like on Sunday they might go up to 65, 66. I can't really see them going that much higher. I think they're all about 62 to 63 right now. I think that's kind of the fair price, and I think that's where I bought a lot of mine. I bought a lot of Farfans for me at like 60K is where I bought Farfan. Now, all these guys right here, the rest of the world dudes, they're all out of packs. Every single one of them is currently not in packs anymore. Only some of the EFL dudes are actually dropping right now. You can see that I think this guy's a rest of the world dude. He was in the last one with Arias. He's like up at 68. I think Arias is 63, so Arias is still one of the cheaper ones. A lot of these guys are down in value. But the reason why I wanted to talk about these specifically today is next Friday, they're going to combine the Ligue 1 and the Calcio A Serie A team of the season. There's going to be two team of the seasons, not combined, but like they're going to be coming out at the same time. And what does that mean? It means double the demand, right? This is something not a lot of people are talking about. Next Sunday, not this upcoming Sunday, because this one's Bundesliga. The one after this one, there's going to be two guaranteed SBCs. You're going to have one for the Calcio and one for the Ligue 1. And everyone's going to have a shot at Neymar and Cavani. And then everyone's going to have a shot at Milinkovic and Mertens, right? Everyone's going to do both. So that means for me, there's going to be double the demand, which I actually really like. I haven't been huge on these cards, and you guys know throughout team of the season, I really haven't done too much investing with these guys. I get it. Some of you guys, I've been recommending them. I've been putting like maybe one of each in my club. You guys saw me get on. I made like 30K a card, 200, 300K for the original EFL team of the season. I get that. I've been doing it a little bit, but I know some dudes who have been buying 100. Sometimes it works out. Sometimes it doesn't. I think next weekend it's going to go up big time, and I think we're going to see all these cards get close to 80. I think realistically, guys, we are getting more of these cards, so that's actually hindering the rise, as I just talked about. However, I really feel like if you have two SBCs on Sunday, right? You've got an 83 for the Calcio A and you've got an 83 for the Ligue 1, both requiring team of the season cards. And then they go up to 75, let's say 73, 74. And then on Tuesday, you do it all over again, right? You have another one that you need two team of the season cards. So that's going to be four team of the season card requirements in the span of like 48 to 72 hours, right? I like that. I think that's good. I think there's a lot of demand there. I think that keeps these cards going up high. I feel like right now, a lot of these cards are over-invested. Now, I feel like 60K, having these guys down at around the 60,000 coin range is fair. I think that's actually a very viable and okay range to have these guys in. I don't really think that a lot of these dudes are going lower than 60. I can't really see these cards going back into the 50s ever again. I think the 60K range for me is actually a very okay range. I think that's where these guys are going to chill. And if a lot of people do the SBCs and that's an actual thing, then these guys do go up. And if they don't, if there's no SBCs, I don't really see them going that much lower. They're only going to really drop off at the end of team of the season when they stop requiring team of the season records. But you guys know that EA have been going crazy and they've been requiring these Team of the Season cards like mad. Like, they are requiring these things for everything. Every SBC we get is one, two. Neymar, look, you go look at Neymar. Is Neymar still available? Neymar, I think Neymar's still available. Yeah, for Neymar and Mbappe, dudes, you guys need, I mean, you need Team of the Season cards. It's just, it's crazy. Like, how many Team of the Season cards you genuinely need for a ton of these SBCs. I think Mbappe, you need two or three. I know Neymar, you need six Team of the Season cards. Six, which is crazy. So I think the more of that kind of stuff that we actually get, it's going to actually have these cards going up more. But I wanted to get on this video and just talk about it with you guys. Like, having two Team of the Seasons out at the same time, and that's not a lot of people. I think a lot of people haven't thought about that. I think that's kind of a thing that everyone's just kind of living it. We're in the Bundesliga right now. Everyone's like, oh yeah, you know, Bundesliga, fun, and we're going to invest in Team of the Season cards. But I think we need to look at it like, holy shit, we're going to get a double Team of the Season requirement. There's still going to be one Team of the Season required for each SBC, but you're going to have double the demand, right? So, because you're going to have two SBCs, I think that's very important. And I also think it's important to look at it like this. Everyone's going to do both SBCs because it's a chance at double the blues on one day. That's awesome, right? Everyone's going to do it. So that's why I think that these cards, here's the game plan, right? If you're not invested in these already, if you bought them at 60, that's fine. Hold them for now. You're good. You don't have to sweat. Sell them Tuesday if you want. If you haven't bought them yet, here's what I would do. I think tomorrow there's a hot shot. If they don't rise to 65 or 70, you could have the opportunity to snipe all of these Team of the Season cards in the under 60,000 range. I think that's very possible, and I think it could happen. If it does, stock up and forget about this whole week. Forget about Tuesday. I don't care if they're required Tuesday and they go up to 70. Just forget about it. Wait until next Sunday when you have the double Team of the Season requirement of two leagues. I really don't. Somebody mentioned it to me too, and they said that they potentially could see EA bringing out something like a Team of the Season and Calcio and Ligue 1 SBC in two, right? So combining both leagues into one SBC and making it a chance at 46 players. I'll tell you something right now, they're not going to do that. And the reason why they're not going to do that is because if they were going to do that, they would have done it with the EFL and the Premier League. So they're going to do them independently. It's going to be double the demand. So I would plan on tomorrow, which is a Sunday, when this SBC drops, if you see these kind of cards start to be panic sold, that's your move. That's when you go in for the kill. You go snipe them all, go pick them all up. So that's what I would do. And if it doesn't happen tomorrow, wait till Thursday or wait till Wednesday or Tuesday or Wednesday. Wait till they come back and it's going to be a whole new release of cards and packs on Wednesday. We've also talked about it though, guys, that like they're becoming higher rated cards now, right? Higher rated cards. Obviously, they're going to be less discard because they're going to be better cards, right? You've got like Talisca coming. You've got Delict, a lot of those kind of cards coming up very soon. And then a quick update on the 83s and the 84s. They're not really dropping off that much, right? So I don't know if I would go crazy. A 1.5K is what you should be paying maximum for the 83s. And what you guys want to be doing is stay away from the goalkeepers. Buy the players that are in good positions. Center mids, right backs, right wings, things like that. And then as far as 84 rateds, let's look at 84s real quick. I don't want to keep you guys here forever. 84 rateds. 84s are under 4. 84s are the better buy. 84s right now are the better buy. Riyad Mahrez has been going to like 9K for these stupid SBCs. He's been going to 8K every time, 7, 8K, down at 4K. If you're going to mass invest something, I would look at stuff like this. This is stuff Riyad Mahrez right now. It's such a good buy. I'm not going to go buy 100 of them, but if I had the will to do that, I would. 85s as well. So you've got 85s as well, like Glick and Otamendi. Are these 85s really this low? And they all go up to 12K. Golds are buys right now, guys. Get involved in these golds. Holy shit. All right, I got to go get some of these for my club after this video. Because these guys are crazy low. 83s, 84s, 85s. Oh my god, they're so low. All right, so these are all going to go back up tomorrow. Although, Bundesliga is probably going to be 83 rated. So I think that's why 83s are staying higher. Okay, but I don't think you can go wrong, man. With the 84s and 85s, I don't think you can go wrong. And I think 83s, you just got to snipe. If they're not at 1.5, you can snipe them. They'll come up during lightning rounds. Trust the boy, they're going to come. Guys, if you enjoyed today's video, smash a like. If you guys have questions in the comments down below, you need to ask them. Tweet at me, ask me in the comments down below, do a little bit of both. I'm trying to get everything. Obviously, there's a lot of you guys who have questions, and I can't literally answer every single one. It's impossible. Try to take as much information from the video as you can and like apply it to foot. If you're gonna go buy one thing from this video right now, I like 84s and 85s. You guys gotta buy center mids, right mids, right backs, left backs, that kind of stuff. And I would look into, because tomorrow's Bundesliga, look into picking up some players who maybe can link well with the Bundesliga. Not necessarily players from the Bundesliga, but maybe Germans or a combination that's in the Bundesliga a lot. Maybe some Brazilians, some Spanish dudes. So that's where I would look, boys. Hope you guys enjoyed the video today. And yeah, I will see you guys all in a video soon. Peace out.